Hello. So to begin with today's lecture, let's again start with sites.google.com, right? And once we are there, we will log in with our email ID, right? Right. So once we are logged in, the main home page where we are supposed to select the site that we are currently creating, right? So by default you will see that this site has been named as untitled site, right? This has a name, untitled site. So let's change that name right now to make it as our first name followed by the first alphabet of our last name, fine. So my first name is anonymous and the first alphabet of my last name is P. So this site name will now be anonymous P, fine. So once we are done that, we will be sure the document has successfully been saved, right. So let's again go here beside publish and let's check whether our site is still live or not. So if I view publish site, I will be shown that my site is live on sites.google.com/view/anonymous-p/home. So today we'll try and learn what this structure actually represents, right? So this HTTPS, this is nothing but the protocol, right? So HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol and S means secured, right? So HTTPS is nothing but a protocol which mentions or which means how this website is supposed to be loaded, fine. How we are supposed to get access to this site. Now sites.google.com is actually the main domain, fine, which is allowing us to create our or host our site, fine. Beyond this sites.google.com, we have /view, right? We have this /view. So this part is called the subdirectory structure, right? For every domain, we have a subdirectory structure. You could think of it as a hard disk, and there are several folders within that hard disk, and different folders within each of the folders, right? So if this part is taken as a storage folder, right? Then the primary folder, the main folder is view, right? The main folder is view. Now within this main folder view, there are multiple users who are using sites.google.com, right? So I am a user who is creating a site. Again, you people are creating sites, and there are many people around the world who are creating their own sites, right? So the main folder for each of us is view, right? So we are supposed to create our own folder within the view folder, right? So my folder's name is anonymous, right? This is my folder's name, fine. This is my folder's name. Similarly, all of you have your own folders within the view main folder, right? Now again, the conventional idea of any website is that the folder that we create, or basically the link that we create, will always have a landing page. It is called a landing page, which is the home page, right? So it is named as home, fine. So if we are trying to conceptualize the whole thing, a main folder provided by Google is view. Within that we are creating our own folder, right? And then within that, Google is automatically providing us with a landing page or another landing folder called home. So let's try out two things. Let's remove this home. Let's hit enter. See, we are back to the same site again, but here home is not shown. But if we want, we can simply put home here and we'll hit enter and we'll come back to the same site again, right? Why is this happening? Let us understand. This is because we only have one site hosted on our domain, fine. We have only one site hosted on our domain or our URL, fine. So within the view folder, within our own folder, we have only one site. So since we have only one site, that site can be referred by both using the actual name, which is anonymous P, or it can be referred by using the name of the landing page, which is the default name, which is anonymous P/home, right? So this site is now viewable by using both the names. We can use it by we can view it by using view anonymous p home, or we can view it by using view anonymous p, right? So this is about the whole structure of the page and why we are getting to see when we are clicking anonymous p at least, and we are getting to see home also, fine. But let's try again something else. Let's just remove this home. Let's replace it by any name. So does that mean that any name will lead us to this site within anonymous p? No, it will tell us 404, the page you entered does not exist, fine. So the page that we have created again is available only under the name that I have specified, or the name I have specified followed by home, right? So this is a problem that we are going to solve right now, and we will want this page to be available under the name myname/cv, right? myname/cv. Now right now myname/cv also does not exist. So today we'll learn how to do this, right? Today we learn how to move our page to myname/cv, right? And also we'll try to address the problem where whenever somebody clicks on myname/cv, they are not redirected to home. So for that we are supposed to create a separate home page or a separate landing page, right? And put some content on it. We'll do that today, right? So back on our website, we'll go to the pages tab on the right hand side of the toolbox, and we'll see that there is a page called home, right? There's a page called home on the right hand side pages part, right? So if we hover over this home page, we'll be shown home, fine. Let's go to the three dot menu here. Let's click on it. Now we will find two or three options, right? The first one is to duplicate the page. Right now we don't want to duplicate it. The second option is properties, right? And the third option is to add a subpage, right? So subpage here, again, if we refer to the first video, we can use folder structures, right? So there will be a main folder and there will be different subfolders under that main folder, fine. So let's start by visiting the properties option. So once we click on properties, there will be two parts. The first one will show name, and there will be a drop down box below with an arrow. Let's click on it. We will be shown that it's an advanced option which is wanting from us a custom path, right? A custom path, or this can be also thought of as a custom folder name, fine. So we had /view/anonymous p, right? And by default the name it follows is home. Since the custom path is not set here, so it works both ways. I can visit /view/anonymous p, I can also visit /view/anonymous p /home. Why? Because this is the home page. This is being treated as the home page with no custom path, fine. So if somebody tries to visit /view/anonymous p/home, they are brought back to that same site, because right now we have only one site, and the default structure says that this site is supposed to be treated as the home page. Am I clear? Right. So this name is home, fine, and the custom path is set to nothing, right? This name is home and the custom path is set to nothing. What we are going to do is we will change this name. Let's change this name to CV, fine. Let's change this name to CV, and let's set the custom path. Now we will set the custom path to CV also. So what is this supposed to do? This is supposed to make our site available on /view/anonymous p/CV, right? So if somebody visits /view/anonymous p, they are not supposed to view anything. If somebody visits /view/anonymous p/home, they are not supposed to see anything. When are they supposed to see our CV? When they are visiting /view/anonymous p/CV. That is the one time that will get that they will get to see our website, fine. So let's click on done, right? So see, the name has been changed, but please notice that this part always will carry this home icon, fine. This part will always carry this home icon, and this has some particular relevance. Now let's do something. Let's click on publish, right? And when we click on publish right now, it will show us two things. The right hand side part shows the currently published home page. That was the previous page. Now please note that the left hand side and the right hand side, that is the draft home page and the currently published home page, show the same thing right now, because there is no actual change in the contents of the page. We are actually moving the page from one location to the other, and the changes are being shown on the extreme left. It is being written, change the page title from home to CV, right? Now let's click on publish. It will show publishing and the site has been published successfully, right? So the previous part, let's come back to the view where we were at sites.google.com/view/anonymous-p/home. Let's simply reload this site. Once we reload this site, it will show us 404, the page you entered does not exist. Fine. So right now this page does not exist. Why? It used to exist previously, right? It does not exist now. Why? Because a few moments back what we did was we changed the default location to /CV, right? We changed the default location, which was bringing us to /home. We changed it and we set it explicitly to /CV. So if somebody wants to view our site, and if they, suppose let's say they go to /view/anonymous-p, they will be shown this page. Why? They will be shown this page. But why? That is because the /CV is again simply a renaming operation that we have done on home. So what was actually home is now CV for us. So if somebody does not even write /CV, they will be redirected to the home location, which is /CV right now, right? So if somebody does not write /CV here, they will be brought to the actual site. And of course, if I write /CV, we will be taken to the same page. Fine. So this is a very, very confusing situation, right? So we are supposed to make it less confusing. So let's go back to the three-dot menu here. Let's click on it and let's go to properties again. We will change this name back to what it was. We will change it back to home. We will go to advanced and we will set the custom path also to home. Let's click on done. Right? Once we are done with it, we will again go to publish and click publish again. Fine. Once we have done that, let's come back to the view of our page where we were at /view/anonymous-p/CV. Let's reload this page. Right now there is no content here, and so we will be shown a 404 error, right? Again, let's go back. Let's try working with only anonymous-p, and we will be able to view the site. And let's explicitly mention /home. Again, we will be able to view the site, but /CV right now does not have any contents. Fine. /CV right now does not have any contents. Now what we are going to do is, we are again gonna come back to the site's portal, and we are simply going to this three-dot menu beside home, right? And we will click on duplicate page, right? We will simply click on duplicate page. The name will be shown as copy of home, and the advanced part will remain empty. Let's simply now go to done, right? Once we have clicked on done, this page has been created, right? This page has been created now. So we have a second page right now, which is called copy of home. Let's click on the three-dot menu. We'll find there are multiple options here, right? Once we click on the three-dot menu, the first option is to set it as a home page. Right, the first option is to set this page as home page, and then we can add a sub page, we can hide the pages from navigation, and we can delete the page. Right, please note that this home page, there is no option to delete, right, because it is mandatory. So whenever somebody creates a site, they have to have one page, at least minimum one page, and that is always the default home page. Fine. Okay. So once we are done with it, let's go to the three-dot menu of copy of home, and let's go to the properties. Now here what we'll do is, we'll change the name from copy of home to CV. We will go to advanced and we will type CV, and we will hit done. Right? So we have home, we have a home page, and we also have a page called CV. Right? We have a home page and we also have a page called CV. And both have the same contents right now. Fine. So we'll simply click on publish. Again, they will show us that we have added a page called CV, right? On the left hand side, you will see the changes is added CV. But both the pages are same. Now, currently published is right now empty because the CV page is, it was not published previously, right? We have just created it right now. So we'll hit publish and the page will be published, fine. So now if we load sites.google.com/view/anonymous-p/CV, now if we load this site, our CV will be shown, fine. Now if we load this site, our CV will be displayed. And if we go to home, now our CV will be displayed. And if we go to anonymous P now, our CV will be displayed. So all the three parts have now been brought to the same location, right? But one thing to note here again is when we are simply doing /view/anonymous-p, when we are simply doing that, our default location is set to the home page, right? Our default location is set to the home page, and the home page now contains what? It contains our CV contents, because that is what we had created in the first lecture, right? Okay. So going back to the sites portal, we will do the last thing for today, which is we will go to this home page. We will click on this home page, right? Once we click on the home icon, once we are back on this home page, we need to do something. What do we need to do? We need to make sure that whenever people are coming to this page, they are redirected. We are giving them an option to actually visit the CV page. So we are going to simply go to this bin icon here, which says delete the header, and we will click on it. The header will be deleted. Fine. Similarly, we will click on this part which says delete the section, and the section will be deleted. What will we do here? We will go to the insert tab on the right hand side toolbox, and we will simply click on text box. A text box has been inserted. We are going to write something here. What are we going to write? We are going to say that please go to the CV here, right? We will simply write please go to the CV, and then we will insert a link. We will insert a hyperlink where the text will be displayed as here. How do we do that? Please follow along. So once we have typed the text, we will find that there is a toolbox just above the text, right? It is there. We have an option called insert link. We will click on it, fine. And we are supposed to select a link. See, by default it is showing us the that there is a link called CV. Let's click on that because that is what we want. But the text we want to change. We will change the text to here, right? So what have we done? Let's try that again. We have gone there, we have gone to insert link. As the link, we have selected the CV page because that is where we want to send the user, right? And as a part of the text, we will write here, right? And we will click on apply. So what does this show? This shows, please go to the CV page here, right? Now let's do some modifications. Let's select the whole text. Let's make it bold. And let's make it a bit bigger, right? Let's make it as a title, and let's bring it to the middle, fine. Once we are done, let's check. So the home page will now show this. Please go to the CV page here. So the user is supposed to click on here, and that will take them to the nothing but the CV page, fine. And the default page is being set as home. Please note that the default page is still set as home, fine. So the home page is set as the default page. When we are going to the CV page options, we have an option of setting it as the home page. But right now we are not going to do that. We are keeping the two separate. So we learn how to hyperlink. So this is a hyperlink. If you remember from your offline lectures that we have learned how to hyperlink to another page, right? How to open one page from within another page using the href tag, right? So here we are doing that using the Google Sites tools, fine. So this is nothing but a hyperlink that we have set up. So let's again go ahead and publish the home page. So this is the home page that we are publishing. So on the changes part, you will see it is written updated home. So we have successfully, or at least we are trying to update the home page, right? So the draft is what the change has been made, and the right hand part shows the currently published format which contained our CV. Let's hit on publish. Right, now once the site has been published, let's go back to the view page, sites.google.com/view/anonymousp, and let's hit enter. Once we hit enter, the default page is set as the home page, right? If you remember, the default page is set as the home page. So the home page is being loaded and we are being shown, please go to the CV page here, and see the remaining text cannot be clicked on, but this here part can be clicked on. So when we click here, our CV page is being loaded. When we click here, our CV page is being loaded. See, sites.google.com/view/anonymousp/CV. So what have we done? We have successfully redirected any user who visits our site, our incomplete site, right? Who tries to visit /view/anonymousp only, who does not remember to visit CV, and somebody hits enter. What have we done is, we are trying to redirect them. We are trying to show them the right way. Please go to the CV page here. They will be clicking on here and they will be brought to the actual page of the CV. So today what we are learning is, or what we have learned is, how to set up the whole directory structure for our Google Sites, right? So whenever some user is trying to use our website, they are being redirected to the correct part. And what is the correct part right now? The correct part is the curriculum vitae page, fine. So this was about setting up the structure of the curriculum vitae page. The last thing that we are going to do today is, we will go back to the pages part, right? You will see that there are two things shown here. One is home, the other is CV. And then there's a settings icon to the left hand side, right? Let's click on the settings icon. It says navigation, right? So there is a navigation setting. It changes are saved automatically and applied the next time we publish the site. And the mode is set to top. We can also set to side, fine. But what if we do not want any navigation settings, right? What if we do not want this navigation settings? Because what happens is, if you again go back to our site, if somebody simply clicks on home, see, we are being brought to home. If somebody clicks on CV, they are being brought here. But right now we do not want that. We do not want to give the user any options, right? Because this is not a contemporary website. We are supposed to have only one web page of our requirement, which is the curriculum vitae page, fine. So in order to remove this navigation pane, the only thing that is to be done, we need to go to the pages tab again. We will go to the three dot menu of our CV page, right? Let's go to the three dot menu of our CV page, and we will simply go to the option hide from navigation. So the CV page will not be shown on the navigation, but this will have a larger effect. How? Let's see. Let us click on this. And you will see that both the home and CV options have disappeared, right? If I again do show in navigation, both the options will reappear. Let's keep it hidden right now. Now, why are they both disappearing, or why are they both appearing together? This is because we have only two pages, and the default page, mind it, is set to the home page, right? The default page is set to the home page. We want the user to visit the CV page. What we have done is, we have redirected an user with a link that is set on the home page. But since there are no other pages other than the CV and the home page, so there is no option of showing them in the navigation. I have disabled the option of showing CV in navigation. So there is no use of showing one single page, that is the default of the home page, in the navigation pane, right? So there is actually no navigation pane content shown on the page. Fine. So once we have done this change, we will, for the last time today, we will click on publish. And as the changes, we will see page last updated time was turned off, anchor links were turned off, and change navigation visibility on CV page. So we have changed the navigation visibility on the CV page, right? So we will simply go ahead and click publish. Fine. So once we have done that, let us simply go ahead and visit the page now. So let's first start off by visiting anonymousp/home. So it tells us please go to the CV page here. Let's click here and we are brought to the CV page, which is anonymousp/CV. This is the page that we want users to visit, and see, there is no navigation pane at all. Fine. So that is all for today's lecture. We will begin by customizing or adding contents to the whole site the next day, right? Take care.